Yo. So, tuloy natin yung discussion about the most efficient cross sections in an open channel. So, after natin ma-discuss yung tungkol sa trapezoidal section, ngayon naman ay discuss natin yung para sa triangular and circular section. So, para sa triangular, or sometimes we call it as V-notch section, ay illustrate natin yung figure. Say, triangular section na yung upper portion ay exposed sa atmosphere or open. So, yung depth ng channel is denoted by D. Yung upper base is denoted as X, similar din dun sa denotation natin for trapezoidal section. At yung sides naman, which is slope or diagonal, ay i-denote din natin as Y. So, yung vertex angle opposite to X ay i-denote natin as theta, at yung kalahati nun syempre is theta over 2. So yung ating triangular section na i-consider dito should be symmetrical. At since yung open channel naman ay structure, so mas economical pa din kung ang built o yung form ng isang structure is symmetrical. So ngayon, i-write down ulit natin yung mga working equations. So, for the representation of the dimensions, yun ay yung hydraulic radius, R is equal to A over P, or the cross-sectional area of flow over the wetted perimeter. So, iti-take natin yung maximum na possible na cross-sectional area. So, assume natin that the liquid flowing on this open channel is full. So, para sa cross-sectional area ng flow, o A, that is equivalent to 1/2 BH. Siyempre, triangular section yan. Or, base sa figure, that is 1/2 X times D. So, para naman sa wetted perimeter, kunin lang natin yung sides, no, which is P is equal to 2 times Y. So, base dun sa ginawa natin for trapezoidal section, gamitin na rin natin yung mga ginamit natin dun na mga working equations. So, take note that Y is equivalent to d secant theta, no? Pero in this case, no, kung titake natin as right triangle, yung kalahati nitong triangular section, eh, yung magiging working equation lang natin for y, o para dun sa sides would be y is equal to d secant theta over 2. Para naman dun sa x o dun sa upper base, that is x is equal to 2d tangent theta over 2. So, ngayon ay substitute lang natin yung values dun sa ating formula for A and P. So, for the cross-sectional area of flow, or A, that is 1/2 XD. So, since X is equivalent to 2D tangent theta over 2, then A is equal to 1/2 2D tangent theta over 2 times D. So, makakancel out na dito yung 1/2 at saka yung 2. So, matitira na lang would be A is equal to d squared tangent theta over 2. Para naman dun sa wetted perimeter, P is equal to 2 times y. So, since ang value ng y is d secant theta over 2, then P is equal to 2 d secant theta over 2. So, ngayon pwede natin scribble tong mga given equations na tulad dun sa mga ginawa natin from our previous examples. Kaya lang, merong similar na function dito tayo makikreate dito sa ating equation for cross-sectional area. So, ngayon kung itatranspose natin, no, yung d squared theta on the left-hand side of the equation, then we can say that tangent theta over 2 is equivalent to a over d squared. So, it means that we can treat as the opposite side, no, ng theta over 2 yung function na a. Also, yung function naman na d square ay pwede naman nating i-treat as the adjacent side. So, paano natin nasabi? Kasi nga, tangent theta over 2 is equal to, syempre, tangent opposite over adjacent. Then, we can convert a over d square as opposite over adjacent na function. So, bakit natin gagawin to? Ito ay para ma-eliminate pa natin yung mga possible na variables na pwedeng ma-include or ma-involve dun sa ating maging working equation. So, para ma-reduce, no, itong mga variables na to, most especially yung theta, ay pwede tayo mag-trigonometric substitution. So, kung ifo-form natin into a right triangle, then the opposite side nga is A, then the adjacent side is D square, then yung included angle o yung vertex angle is theta over 2. Then, yung hypotenuse naman, since hypotenuse is C square is equal to A square plus B square, or simply, the square root of A squared plus D raised to 4. So ngayon, since ang gagamitin nga nating working equation, yung usual na ginagamit natin, which is the wetted perimeter, since kailangan nga nating ma-optimize itong wetted perimeter na to to get the least dimensions possible. So ngayon, kunin natin no, yung function na secant theta over 2 base dito sa na-create natin na right triangle. So secant theta over 2 is equivalent to, syempre, secant theta is 1 over cosine, and also equivalent to the hypotenuse over the adjacent. So secant theta over 2 is also equivalent to the square root of A square plus D raised to 4 as the hypotenuse all over the adjacent side, which is D squared. So substitute na natin yung na-form natin na equation. So gagamitin nga natin working equation is the wetted perimeter, since P is equal to 2D secant theta over 2. Then secant theta over 2 is equivalent to the square root of A squared plus D raised to 4 all over D squared. Then P is equal to 2D times the quantity of the square root of A squared plus D raised to 4 all over D squared. So maka-cancel out na dito yung D. So pag na-cancel out na yung D, then P is equal to 2 times the square root of A squared plus D raised to 4 all over D. So, and may nabuo na tayong working equation. So, kung papansin nyo, ay isa na lang yung independent variable para dito sa ating working equation. At yun ay D. So, na-eliminate na natin dito yung theta. Pero pwede rin naman natin i-involve dito yung theta. So, kung ganun, di magpa-partial differentiation tayo. Pero in this case, na-eliminate na nga natin siya, ay pwede na tayong mag-take or mag-obtain kung ano yung first derivative ng ating equation. At since fraction to, pwede tayong mag-quotient rule. So, treat natin yung numerator as U, then yung denominator as V. So, calculate na natin yung first derivative ng equation. So, that is dp over dd is equal to, so that is vdu minus udv over v square. So, v is d times, so, ilagay na natin yung constant dito na 2. So, take natin yung first derivative ng square root of a squared plus d raised to 4. So, since yan ay a squared plus d raised to 4 raised to 1 half, using chain rule, that is 1 half times a squared plus d raised to 4. So, minus tayo ng 1 dun sa ating exponent, that is 1 half minus 1, that is equivalent to negative 1 half. So, that would be raised to negative 1 half times the derivative of u. So, ngayon, kunin natin yung derivative ng function, which is a squared plus d raised to 4. So, yung derivative ng a squared is 0, since constant yan. Then, yung derivative ng d raised to 4 is 4d cubed. So, gumamit lang din tayo ng chain rule. Plus 0. So, magiging 0 na to, no? Since ang derivative ng 2 is 0 since constant nga yung 2. Minus udv. So, u is 2 times the square root of a square plus d raised to 4 times the derivative of v. That is 1. So, yung derivative ng d ay 1. All over d square. So, yung sunod na step ay equate nga natin yung dp over dd to 0. So, once na ma-equate natin yun, at i-cancel out natin yung mga common factors, as well as kapag minultiply natin both sides by d square, ay makakancel out na rin natin yung denominator na d square sa right-hand side of the equation. So, yung resulting equation would be 0 is equal to 4d raised to 4 all over the square root of a square plus d raised to 4, since dun sa numerator, ang indicated dun is the quantity of a square plus d raised to 4 raised to negative 1 half minus 2 times the square root of a square plus d raised to 4. So, evaluate further pa natin yung ating equation. So, transpose natin yung 2 times the square root of a square plus d raised to 4 sa left-hand side of the equation. That is 2 times the square root of a square plus d raised to 4 equals 4d raised to 4 all over the square root of a square plus d raised to 4. So, since common dito yung 2, no? As well as common din yung square root of a square plus d raised to 4, pwede nating multiply both sides by the square root of a square plus d raised to 4 over 2. So, ayun ang magiging resulting equation na would be, so, matitira na lang dito ay a square plus d raised to 4 is equal to 2d raised to 4. So, upon transposing, that would become a square is equal to 2d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4. Then, a square is equal to d raised to 4. So, taking the square root of both sides of the equation, yung magiging resulting equation na would be minimized into a, or the cross-sectional area of flow is equal to d square. So, ngayon, ibig sabihin pala, for the most efficient cross-section in a triangular open channel, A, or the cross-sectional area of flow, should be equal to d square. So, ngayon, if A is equal to d square, determine natin ano ba dapat yung maging value ng theta, no? O yung vertex angle for the most efficient cross-section of a triangular open channel. So, balikan natin yung ating naging working equation. So, gamitin natin yung equation na tangent theta over 2 is equal to a over d square. Since, nandito na sa equation na to yung function na a, no? As well as yung theta. So, ngayon, tangent theta over 2 is equal to, so substitute natin yung value na a is equal to d square to a. So, tangent theta over 2 is equal to d square all over d square. So, makakancel out na dito si d square. At matitira na lang syempre ay 1. So, tangent theta over 2 is equal to 1. Then, theta over 2 is equal to the inverse tangent of 1. So, inverse tangent 1 is equivalent to 45 degrees. Then, multiplying both sides to 2, we can get theta is equal to 90 degrees. So, ibig sabihin pala, for the most efficient cross-section for a triangular open channel, the vertex angle of that V-notch open channel should be equal to 90 degrees. So, ito na yung ating mga gagamitin or mga posible nating maging working equations pag nag-solve tayo for the most efficient cross-section of a triangular open channel. A is equal to d square, then theta is equal to 90 degrees. So, yung last naman na i-discuss natin ay yung tungkol sa circular section. So, illustrate muna natin gamit ang ating paboritong soothing gel for all types of skin, 99.85% aloe vera, paraben-free, alcohol-free, and no artificial color. So, gaya nga nasabi ko tungkol sa flow ng liquid sa open channel, ay dapat may portion dun sa liquid na exposed sa atmosphere. So, kailangan ng airspace, no? Kung closed yung conduit kung ititreat natin siya as an open channel. So, for a closed circular section ay provided dapat yung airspace within the cross-section of the channel. So, ito nga yung circular section na open channel. Then, yung depth ng liquid is denoted as lowercase d. Then, yung diameter naman nung circular na open channel is represented by uppercase d. So, ngayon ay maiiba na yung way ng pagkakalculate natin dito for the most efficient cross-section, unlike dun sa nauna nating mga examples. Pero same pa rin yung ating objective. So, kailangan pa rin nating ma-obtain dun sa open channel yung maximum flow with the least or the minimum wetted perimeter. So, bali, ang gagamitin na nating working equation ay yung equation for the flow rate in an open channel. So, using Manning's formula, that is Q is equal to A over N times R raised to 2/3 S raised to 1/2. At gaya nga dun sa objective na nabanggit natin, kailangan nga nating ma-obtain is the maximum flow or Q max. So, ang sunod ay set natin yung mga constants. So, yung titreat natin na constant dito, halos same pa rin yung roughness coefficient N, yung slope. So, yung R dito, syempre hindi na yun magbabago eh. No? Titreat na rin natin siya as constant as well as yung diameter. Kaya lang, yung cross-sectional area of the flow ay di na natin matitreat as constant. Kasi nga yung cross-sectional area of flow will depend on what would be the computed depth, no, required for the most efficient cross-section. Kaya unlike dun sa mga previous examples natin, ay hindi natin ititreat as constant nga yung cross-sectional area of flow. So ngayon, pagsamasamahin natin yung lahat ng constants in one function. So, treat natin as single constant value yung mga constant dito sa ating working equation, which is N and S. So, gawin natin yung working equation natin na Q is equal to C times A times R raised to 2/3, wherein yung value ng C is S raised to 1/2 over N, since titreat nga natin as constant values itong mga functions na to. So, same pa din, ang representation pa rin ng dimensions, no, na required for our cross-section would be the hydraulic radius, which is R is equal to A over P. So, ngayon, determine natin kung ano yung value for A and P. So, simulan natin sa cross-sectional area of flow or A. So, ngayon, sa pag-compute ng cross-sectional area of flow, hindi nga natin ititreat, no, as flowing full itong flow ng liquid sa ating open channel. So, para makompute natin yung total area, ay compute natin siya by portion. So, hatiin natin yung area, no, para dun sa cross-sectional area of flow. So, para dun sa area number 1, so, yun yung triangle that is formed from the center of the circle up to the liquid surface or the top surface of the flowing liquid. At base dito sa ating illustration, yung two sides, no, nung triangle na yon is represented by the radius of the circle. At yung natitira naman, which is represented by area number 2 or A sub 2, is the cross-sectional area that is being formed by the arc created by the liquid in contact to the open channel. So, bali dalawang portion yung i-consider natin. So, the total area is equivalent to A sub 1 plus A sub 2. So, for A sub 1, syempre, ang formula para sa area of a triangle is A is equal to 1/2 BH. So, iset natin dito sa ating figure kung alin yung B and alin yung H. Syempre, yung B, yung width ng liquid surface, no? At yung H, yung height from the center of the circle up to the liquid surface. So, ngayon, iset natin yung vertex angle, no, in opposite to the base. So, yung vertex angle is denoted by theta. So, kung hatiin natin yon referring on H, then it is theta over 2. So, bakit mahalaga na magkaroon tayo ng vertex angle? Yun ay para maset natin yung values ng B and H na in terms of the essential dimensions para dun sa circle, which is radius or diameter. So compute natin yung value ng B and H na in terms of radius. Since involved din naman yung radius dun sa ating figure na triangle, no? At yun yung tingkabilang sides nito. So, kunin natin yung half of that triangle. So, yung opposite side dun sa theta over 2 is B over 2. Then, yung hypotenuse would be R. Then, yung adjacent side would be H. So, para ma-determine natin yung values ng B and H ay gamit tayo ng mga trigonometric functions. So, para sa B, since B is the opposite side, then we can use sine or so. Opposite over hypotenuse, and hypotenuse is R. So, sine theta over 2 is equal to B over 2, since kalahati lang yung tinik natin dun sa triangle, all over R. Then, the value of B is 2R sine theta over 2. So, para naman dun sa value ng H, then since H is the adjacent side, then we can use cosine ka. So, cosine theta over 2 is equal to H or the adjacent side all over hypotenuse, which is R. Then, yung value ng H is equivalent to R cosine theta over 2. So, ngayon, substitute na natin yung values ng B and H dun sa ating formula na parehas na in terms of R. So, A sub 1 is equal to 1/2 B. So, yung value ng B is 2 sine theta over 2 times H. So, H is R cosine theta over 2. So, ngayon, pwede natin i-cancel out yung 1/2 and yung 2, syempre. So, that is equal to 1. Then, A sub 1 is equal to R squared sine theta over 2 cosine theta over 2. So, ngayon, pwede pa nating i-minimize yung function na sine theta over 2 times cosine theta over 2. Similar to dun sa double angle identity. So similar yung function na yun dun sa double angle identity for sine 2 theta. At since sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cosine theta, pero here in my example, I wrote sine x. Cosine x is also equivalent to 1 half sine 2x. So, parehas lang din naman yun, no? Na-transpose lang natin yung 2 sa kabilang side ng equation. So, using this identity, ay magiging resulting equation na natin would be 1 half r squared sine theta. So, bakit naging sine theta na lang? Since double angle identity nga, kailangan nating i-multiply to 2 yung ating angle theta. And since our angle theta is theta over 2, then 2 times theta over 2 is equivalent to theta. So, ang sunod naman ay yung area number 2, no? O A sub 2, o yung area nung sector that is being included nga by the arc, which is formed by the liquid which is in contact to the circular open channel. At syempre, ang area for a sector is the theta or yung included angle all over 360 o yung full revolution times the full area of that circle. So, in this case, ang i-consider nating theta ay syempre yung included angle nga na tinutukoy natin for the sector at hindi yun yung theta. So, yun yung opposite na angle na kapag binawas natin yung theta dun sa full revolution. So, that's 360 minus theta. So, ngayon, yun na yung included angle. So, magiging formula na natin for A sub 2 is 360 minus theta all over 360 times the full area of that circle. So, since in terms of R na yung ating A sub 1, gamitin natin yung area for the circle na in terms of R. That's pi R squared. So, ngayon, try pa nating i-minimize yung ating equation. So, ngayon, so pwede nating i-convert itong expression na 360 minus theta over 360. So, pwede nating i-convert, no, itong 360 minus theta na in terms of radian. Kasi nga, meron na tayong over 360 dito eh. At syempre, included na rin sa ating formula yung pi. So, tandaan natin na ang value ng 360 degrees in terms of radian is 2 pi. So, kapag minultiply natin yung ating right-hand side of the equation by 2 over 2, so 2 over 2, maka-cancel out lang din naman yun, ay maka-convert natin yung 360 minus theta na in terms of radian kasi lalabas sa dito yung 2 pi over 360. So, yung magiging resulting equation would be A sub 2 is equal to 1 half 360 minus theta in terms of radian times r squared. So, ngayon, yung total area na i-consider natin, that is A, is equivalent nga to A sub 1 plus A sub 2. So, upon substituting dun sa mga computed natin pa na mga values for A sub 1 and A sub 2, that is A is equal to 1 half R square sine theta plus 1 half times the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian times r squared. So, yung magiging resulting equation na natin for area is 1 half r squared times the quantity of sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian. So, ito na yung gagamitin natin na posibleng working equation para sa ating solution later on. So, ang sunod naman ay yung para sa wetted perimeter. So, ganun lang din. Kunin lang natin yung circumference para dun sa arc na included ng 360 minus theta. So, for the wetted perimeter, that is the ratio, no, of the included angle over the full revolution, which is 360 degrees times the formula for the circumference of a full circle. So, that is 2 pi r since in terms of r na yung ating cross-sectional area. So, yung magiging working equation natin for P ay P is equal to 360 minus theta over 360 times 2 pi r. So, ngayon pwede ulit natin i-minimize to since given na nga dito sa ating formula yung 2 pi over 360. So, ibig sabihin pwede natin convert yung expression na 360 minus theta na in terms of radian. So, P is equal to r times the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian. So, ayun, na-compute na natin yung A and yung P. siguro makukompute na rin natin kung ano yung magiging value for our hydraulic radius R. So, kopyahin lang natin, R is equal to A over P, then R is equal to 1/2 R squared times the quantity of sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian all over the wetted perimeter, which is R times the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian. So, cancel out na natin dito yung radius. So, R or hydraulic radius is equal to 1/2 R times sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian all over 360 minus theta in terms of radian. So, ngayon, i-substitute na natin, no? Itong na-compute natin na value for the hydraulic radius to our working equation, which is Q. So, Q or the flow rate is equal to CA times R raised to 2/3. So, ngayon, substitute natin yung values para sa A and sa R. So, the equation would become Q is equal to C times the quantity of 1/2 R squared times the quantity of sine theta plus 360 minus theta in terms of R times the quantity of 1/2 R times sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of radian all over 360 minus theta in terms of radian raised to 2/3. So, ngayon, i-minimize pa natin yung ating equation, no? So, ngayon, yung ating equation ay pwede pa nating i-minimize by collecting all the constants involved in the equation. So, ngayon, constant na dito yung C, no? That is represented by S and N. Pero may natitira pang constants pa dito sa ating working equation, which is R, o yung radius. So, pwede natin siyang pagsamasamahin pa at buuin into a single constant. So, ngayon, itong single constant na to ay denote natin as B, wherein B is also equivalent to C times yung values ng constants, which is yung 1/2 at saka yung R. So, that is B is equal to C times the quantity of 1/2 R squared times the quantity of 1/2 times R. Also, common din sa ating working equation yung function na sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta na in terms of radian. So, ngayon, since dun sa kabilang expression for R na raised to 2/3, i-distribute natin yung exponents na 2/3 on both numerator and denominator. So, makakapag-come up tayo dun sa ating working equation na Q is equal to B times sine theta plus 360 minus theta in terms of radian raised to 5/3, since i-add natin yung exponents para sa expression na sine theta plus 360 minus theta in terms of radian as 1 plus 2/3. So, equivalent nun ay 5/3. So, that is all over 360 minus theta in terms of radian raised to 2/3. So, ito na yung na-create natin na working equation, no? Na minimize pa na working equation. At pwede na nating i-take or i-optimize pa itong equation na to by getting the first derivative. Ayan, so before getting the first derivative, ay i-convert na natin, no? Yung 360 and yung theta as in terms of radian or in radian form. So, yun ay para ma-differentiate natin ng tama, no, yung ating working equation, no? So, yung 360 would be converted into constant, no? Na in radian form kasi hindi natin makukuha yung kanyang derivative, no? If it is in terms of degrees, maliban na lang kung siya ay variable. So, ngayon, yung theta would be in terms of radian na rin, no? Pero hindi yung theta na within sine function. So, gagawin lang natin to para maayos yung ating differentiation. So, the first derivative, dq over d theta. So, ang ating independent variable is theta. So, gagamit tayo dito ng quotient rule. So, quotient rule is vdu minus udv over v squared, wherein yung numerator is u, then the denominator is v. So, hiwalay na natin dito yung constant value na b. So, gagawin natin yun kasi nga, pag nag-product rule tayo, magiging zero lang din, no, yung kabilang portion ng magiging equation natin. So, kunin na lang natin yung first derivative using quotient rule. So, vdu, so yung v, is yung 360 minus theta na in terms of radian, that is also equivalent to 2 pi minus theta sub r, or in terms of radian, raised to 2/3 times du, So, yung derivative nung numerator using quotient rule is 5/3 times the quantity of sine theta plus 2 pi minus theta sub r, or in terms of region, raised to, so minus tayo ng 1 dun sa 5/3, that would become 2/3. So, kunin natin yung derivative naman nung loob, no? So, that is du. So, that is equivalent also to cosine minus 1. So, magiging 0 na dito yung 2 pi. Minus u dv. So, u is sine theta plus the quantity of 360 minus theta in terms of region, which is also equivalent to sine theta plus 2 pi minus theta sub r, or in terms of region, raised to 5/3 times dv. So, that is using quotient rule. So, that would become 2/3 times the quantity of 2 pi minus theta sub r, or in terms of region, raised to, so yung 2/3 mag-minus tayo ng 1, that would become negative 1/3 times the derivative of u, which is the derivative of theta, that is negative 1. So, kasi magiging 0 na nga dito yung 2 pi. So, ngayon, ang sunod na step na gagawin natin ay equate natin yung dq over d theta to 0 to optimize our equation. So, mangyayari ay pwede na nating i-cancel out dito yung denominator, which is 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to 2/3, kasi nga pwede nating i-multiply both sides by that function. Also, pwede na rin nating ma-cancel out dito yung constant b. So, similar lang din dun sa ginawa natin dun sa ating denominator, kasi pwede na nga natin siyang ma-cancel out. So, let's evaluate further. So, pwede pa pala natin nga pa nang ma-cancel out dito yung 1/3, no? Kasi similar siya on both remaining na expressions. So, once ma-cancel out natin yun, yung matitira na lang is 5 times the quantity of 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to 2/3 times the quantity of sine theta plus 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to 2/3 times the quantity of cosine theta minus 1 plus 2 times sine theta plus 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to 5/3 times the quantity of 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to negative 1/3. So ngayon, pwede pa nating i-minimize to, no, by dividing the expressions to its common factor. So, kung titingnan natin, or kung inspect natin dun sa mga given functions nga dito sa ating working equation, ay pwede nating i-divide both sides by 2 pi minus theta sub r raised to negative 1/3 times 2 pi plus sine theta minus theta sub r raised to 2/3. So, by this, ay mapapaigsipan natin, no, yung ating magiging equation. At para hindi ganong kahaba yung may input natin sa ating calculator later on, kung gusto nating compute-in yung value ng theta. So, yung matitira na lang dun sa ating equation is 0 is equal to the quantity of 5 times 2 pi minus theta sub r times the quantity of cosine theta minus 1 plus the quantity of 2 times the quantity of 2 pi plus sine theta minus theta sub r. So, ngayon, ang gagawin natin ay gamitin na lang natin yung power ng ating calculator para makompute natin yung value ng theta. Dahil nga rin, medyo complicated yung form ng ating equation. So, ang gagawin natin ay, once mag-input tayo sa calculator, yung value ng theta would be represented by x. Kaya lang yung theta in terms of region ay co-convert nga natin in terms of region. So, i-multiply pa natin siya into pi over 180 degrees. Ayan, so input lang natin yung values at gamitin natin yung function na shift solve ng ating calculator. So, base dun sa ating figure, yung magiging initial guess natin for our shift solve should be in range between 0 and 180. No? So, hindi naman siya lalampas ng 180 at siyempre, hindi rin naman siya 0. So, ang input nating value ay siguro 100 na lang para safe. At hintayin natin kung ano yung magiging value. So, ayun, yung computed value natin for theta is 57.5867 degrees. So, pwede natin tandaan to, no? So, for the most efficient cross-section pala, for a circular open channel, yung theta, which is the angle opposite to the width of the liquid surface at the open channel, is equivalent to 57.5867 degrees. 5867 degrees. So ngayon ay balikan natin yung ating naging objective. So kailangan nga nating ma-obtain ay yung maximum flow rate or Q max. So na-obtain natin dito na maximize natin yung Q na ang makokompute pala nating theta for that is 57.5867. So ang condition natin dito ay for maximum flow rate. So yun. So balikan natin yung ating figure at i-determine natin yung value nung depth na required, no? If we try to obtain what is the maximum flow rate, no? On a circular open channel. So, yun nga, nakompute nga nating value of theta is 57.5867. So, compute natin yung value nung B. So, para makompute natin yung value nung B, no? Ay equivalent siya dun sa sum nung radius at saka nung value nung h, no, na dininote natin kanina from our previous figure. So ngayon, makukompute naman natin yung value nung h, no, na in terms of radius base dun sa ating naging working equations kanina. So h is equal to r cosine theta over 2. Since na-compute na nga natin yung value nung theta, makukompute na natin yung value nung h. So ngayon, since ang usual naman na pinapresent nating data with regards to pipes and channels, no, lalo na pag circular yan, ay diameter. So, in terms of B or diameter natin, yung ating R. So, ngayon, since B o yung depth is equal to R plus H, then R plus, yung value ng H is R cosine theta over 2, convert natin yung R into D over 2 or radius. So, R is also equivalent to the diameter divided by 2. So, it is also equal to D or diameter over 2 plus D or the diameter over 2 times cosine of theta, which is 57.5867 degrees over 2. So, okay. So that is also equivalent to 0.5 distance, 1 half is 0.5. Plus, kinompute na natin, you know, yung value ng 1 half cosine 57.5867 over 2 at ang value niya ay 0.438. So to sum it up, yung value pala nung depth, no, nung liquid flowing in a circular open channel, no, obtaining the maximum flow rate, no, is also equivalent to 0.938 of the diameter of that circular open channel. So, kung in terms of percentage, that is also equivalent to 93.8% of the diameter of the circular open channel. Ayun. So, take note lang, no, ito ay kung gusto nating i-obtain ay yung maximum flow, no. Pero syempre, ma-obtain nga natin yung maximum flow kapag ka-flowing full. Kaya lang ang condition nga natin is that kailangan magkaroon tayo ng airspace, no, para mag-furnish yung flow. Kasi nga, open channel yung ating conduit. So, to obtain the maximum flow rate or Qmax, we need to set as the depth of the liquid should be 93.8% of the diameter of the circular open channel. So, ito ay para sa maximum flow rate. At take note lang, no, to obtain the maximum velocity naman, so magkaiba yung condition for maximum flow rate and maximum velocity. So, for Vmax or the maximum velocity, so similar lang din yung magiging calculation natin dito. So, hindi ko lang siya inulit, pero ito yung magiging result natin. So, B should be 82% of the diameter of the circular open channel or also equivalent to D is equal to 0.82 times the diameter of the open channel. At yun lang para sa video na to. Sana may natutunan kayo at see you on our next video. Thank you so much.